Beloved, all grace, mercy, and peace be yours and mine from God and from our Savior, Jesus Christ. Amen. What a difference a few weeks can make. In our readings today from Luke and Acts, we see the disciples reacting to Jesus' ascension with great joy. Whereas just a few weeks ago, after the crucifixion, they had scattered in disarray and fear, worried that the same fate would befall them. They had run, fleeing for their lives. And when they came together, they huddled in a room with a locked door, the scripture tells us, not once, but twice, because their fear had totally paralyzed them. Once they had been confident of their ability to go forth and accomplish the mission that had been entrusted to them, now they knew not which way to turn or what to do. Without Jesus, they were lost. Many of us can relate to that situation. We gather regularly around God's immeasurable grace come to us in word and sacrament, prayer and fellowship, God who is present with us in this Christian community. And yet when we go out on our own, it's a very different story. Trying to translate our Sunday faith into Monday living can be very overwhelming, because we live in a very non-sectarian, don't push your religious beliefs on me, carefully construed, boundary-laden work, social, and learning environments. And so we don't always know what to do with faith, how to live out this mission, Christ's mission, that has been entrusted to us as witnesses. And so in that disjointed middle place, with one foot in the kingdom of God and the other firmly planted in the world, we find ourselves in a position not unlike the disciples in the scripture readings today, like the disciples before they returned from the ascension event with such great joy. But you see, with renewed confidence, they were ready to get about the business of being and becoming the church. They would be the ones to demonstrate what it's like to live out the gospel. And so when their beloved Lord was taken from them again, when the clouds received them, when there was no more sky gazing for them, at least not for long, their sights became firmly locked into serving Christ among the people. How does the scripture say it? By their witness, the word would begin to spread in and around Jerusalem, and it would go out into far-off places like Middletown and Braddock Heights and Myersville and Frederick, and even as far as Boonesboro. And then finally, the scripture says it would go to the far reaches of the earth, you know, places like Charlestown and D.C. and even Baltimore. Because you see, up until that ascension moment, Jesus was seen only where he was, in and around the towns surrounding Galilee. Now with his ascension to sit at the right hand of God the Father, Jesus becomes Lord of heaven and earth, present in all ways, always. In the ascension, Jesus would be no longer confined to a single space or a single moment, but that Jesus would be alive by the power of the Spirit for all people, for all time. That sacred moment in our scripture on the Mount of Bethany opened the way for Christ's message to spread throughout the world forever, wherever people live in the Spirit, even as the Spirit lives in us. Before I came to be wise to teach children words like Himmelfahrt, I tried to explain the ascension to the children once in a children's sermon, and one kid started stomping their feet saying, "But where is his body?" And if we scan the sky one last time, Luke, writing in the Acts of the Apostles, foresaw such a question. And so the angels ask the disciples, Why are you standing here looking up to heaven? The body you look for is not there. And then they start to look around and realize, we are his body. Look in the mirror when you look for Christ. Look, as Luther says, in one another and be little Christs for one another. But know that you are not Christ's body alone. Rather, we are the body of Christ, the church, together. We are Christ's body, gathering week by week around Scripture in praise of one who is far above all other powers and principalities, the one who is still alive among the weak, the poor, and the humble of this world. We are the body, gathered to eat at a table that is open to all, living out for all to taste and see the promise of thy kingdom come on earth as it will be in heaven. We are the body gathered to baptize and welcome new disciples, bearing witness to the daily miracle and possibility of new birth, a second chance, and a living hope. We are the body that gathers to celebrate the mystery of love between two become one, and seeing in their faithfulness a strong echo of Christ's own faithfulness to us. We are the body gathered to forgive sin, proclaiming the deeply subversive good news that you and I are freed and forgiven. We are the body that gathers to lovingly care after its sick members, attempting to mirror in our life together God's own infinite compassion and mercy. Even in death, we are the body that gathers to honor a life and tenderly honor the body that once served it. We are the body of Christ, the body gathered and washed, fed and sent out by Christ in service to the world. And so now it's our turn. It's our turn to proclaim the Lord's message of love and forgiveness, to bring the good news of the gospel to a weary, sin-scarred, and most unfortunately, war-torn and terror-filled world. Because in this mess, our ascended Lord calls us to take up the cross and to hold fast and share good news. For Christ, who once went before us, now in his ascension, goes above us, walks beside us, lives within us, works through us to encourage and empower others to make a difference in the world too. And so, gathered and fed and sent from this place, we become a little bit of Christi Himmelfahrt, the ascended Lord. We go boldly to be the church, the body of Christ in the world, and empower with eyes wide open, daily reclaiming our baptismal inheritance to live in faith, to act in love, to make Christ known in word and deed for this world that God still so loves. In Jesus' name, amen. I tell you, I worked really hard on that sermon. And you know what? I'm a little disappointed, because the only thing you're going to remember from today is about the Himmelfahrt. I know. Let us then center our worship now as we lift up our hearts and our voices together in joyous song. Please rise as you are able. Living together in trust and hope, we confess our faith, saying, we believe in one God, the Father, the Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, of all that is seen and unseen. We believe in one Lord, Jesus Christ, the only Son of God, eternally begotten of the Father, God from God, light from light, true God from true God, begotten, not made, of one being with the Father. Through him all things were made. For us and for our salvation, he came down from heaven. By the power of the Holy Spirit, he became incarnate from the Virgin Mary and was made man. For our sake, he was crucified under Pontius Pilate. He suffered death and was buried. On the third day, he rose again in accordance with the Scriptures. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again in glory to judge the living and the dead, and his kingdom will have no end. We believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the giver of life, who proceeds from the Father and the Son, who with the Father and the Son he is worshipped and glorified. He has spoken through the prophets. We believe in one holy Catholic and apostolic church. We acknowledge one baptism for the forgiveness of sins. We look for the resurrection of the dead and the life of the world to come. Amen. In our prayers today, we remember all of those on our parish prayer list, but there are some that I would invite your particular intention for. Bruce Albright is hospitalized at Johns Hopkins in Baltimore, and Bruce is experiencing congestive heart failure. And the options before him are very serious. And so I invite your prayers for Bruce and his family. I also invite your prayers for Lorene Huffer. Lorene is at Frederick Memorial, and she had a fall and then some memory problem after she woke up from that fall. And so she is being cared for as well. I invite your prayers for Lorene. I also ask your prayers for the family and the extended family and friends of Mary Smith, who passed from this life into eternal life last weekend and who was laid to rest on Friday. For these and for those on our hearts, let us come before God's throne of grace, trusting in his mercy. Let us pray. Gracious and living God, we give you thanks for the gift of Jesus, who walking among us has left the footprints of your love, your mercy, and your compassion on our hearts and our lives. Help us to be the church, the body of Christ alive in the world, bearing the good news of your redeeming love. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. We pray, O God, that you would bless our noisy offering and that Hartley House and its mission and ministry would be extended by our generosity. Be with our young people who continue to remind us of the joy of stewardship and who invite us to give so much of our hearts, our lives, and our labors. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. We pray for the needs of those who are ill, those who are hospitalized, those who are dealing with chronic illness, mental health concerns, and addiction. We pray for those who are near and dear to us, particularly for Tim and Linda and Anne, for James, Jim, and Darla, for Jurgen and Nancy, for Bob and Melissa, for Bruce and Cheryl and Lorene, for Casey and Kathy, for Jason, Linda, and Jackie, for Trish, Ron, Bill, and Clark, for Francis, Doris, for Donna, for Larry, for Dolores and Eric and Skippy, for Sarah, Pat, Melvin, for Buddy, Tom, and Bonnie, for Janet, John, Sarah, and Anna, for Kathy and Anna and Mariana, for Marty, for Ruby, for Jean, Addison, Kevin, Deb, and Janice. We pray for these and those that we remember now in the quiet places of our hearts. Help us to be a healing presence for all whom you love. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. We pray for the mission of Zion Church, that from this place the word should go out from Middletown into all the world. Help us to live into the high calling to be a beacon in the valley, and help us to shine with the light and the love of Jesus. Lord, in your mercy, we pray resurrection promise for the family of Mary and for all of those who mourn. May our grief give way to faith, may our faith give way to resurrection, and may resurrection give us again in your time joy. Lord, in your mercy, for these things, O God, and for all else that you see that we need, grant it not for our sake, but in the name of the one who is, who was, and who is still to come, even Jesus Christ, our Lord. Amen. The peace of the risen Lord be with you always. Turn to your neighbor and share a sign of Christ's peace one with another. You may be seated, and with glad and generous hearts, let us return to God the first fruits of our labors as we bring our gifts and our tithes in the morning offering. Please rise as you are able. Almighty God, we give you thanks for the gift of the offerings of our lives and our labors, for the offering for the mission of this congregation, and for the noisy offering that we bring for Hartley House. Bless our gifts that divided and shared, they might be enough, and they might be generosity, to overwhelm our ministry and our world with the love of God made known to us in Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. The Lord be with you. Lift up your hearts. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. Take this bread, I give it for you, and as you do, remember me. This bread is my body broken for you. Take it, eat it, and as you do, remember me. Take this cup, I give it for you, and as you do, remember me. This cup is my blood poured out for you. Take it, drink it, and as you do, remember me. Take my life, I give it for you, and as you do, remember me. Remember me. Remember me. Send now your Holy Spirit upon these gifts and into our hearts, that we would receive the Lord with a living faith as he comes to us in his Holy Supper. We pray and ask in Jesus' name. Amen. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory, forever and ever. The Lamb of God that takes away the sin of the world, happy are we now who come to taste and see that God is good. Amen. You may be seated. As you come forward today, receive the bread, the body of Christ, in your open hand. Choose an empty cup, which will be filled with wine, or choose a pre-filled cup of grape juice, and in that way receive the body and blood of the Lord. There are baskets at the ends of the aisle to receive your spent glasses as you return to your places. This is the Lord's table. All are welcome.
With grateful heart, give thanks to the Lord.
The body of our Lord Jesus Christ, with his precious blood, strengthen us and keep us together in grace from now until life everlasting. Amen. I don't know that I want to jinx it, but that was the most perfect communion service we've had since I got here. Now watch, something disastrous will happen at 11, but I think we might have figured it out. We might have made it. Whew! Let us pray. Almighty God, you have refreshed us with the healing power of this gift of life, so renew in us the very life of Jesus, that we might go and be the church alive in the world, for we pray and ask through Christ our Lord. Amen. Thank you, everyone, for being in worship today. It has been a great day to worship God, and it has been a good day to be together as a community. Won't you please rise as you're able and let us bow our heads and pray for God's blessing. Go into the world in peace, be of good courage. Render to no one an evil thing for an evil thing. Strengthen the faint-hearted, support the weak, comfort the afflicted, cry out for justice. Honor all people. Love and serve the Lord. May the blessing of Almighty God, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit be with us now and forever. Amen. Let us lift up our hearts and our voices in joyous song.
Let's sing this great song, Take to the World, about leaving this sanctuary and going out into the mission field. Here we go. 1, 2, 3, 4.
Go in peace. To love and to serve, let your ears ring long with what you have heard. May the bread on your tongue leave a trail of crumbs. Lead the hungry back to the way that you are from.
As a people of God, we share Christ's love, grow in faith, and serve others. Go in peace, serve the Lord. Hallelujah.
Thanks be to God. Hallelujah.
Have a great week, everyone.
and take to the world this love, this hope. And